You got a de-essing plugin. Why would you manually de-ess using automation? Stay tuned and find out. Kush after hours. All right, they can't all be sexy, so we got one more sexy one coming. But for now, let's hit something a little bit more buttoned up. Let's talk about de-essing. I use de-essers all the time. In my experience and my opinion, I have yet to find any de-esser, analog or digital, which can just be set a specific way and then will work for every S and T, for every K and CH that's happening inside a mix. There's just going to be certain ones that are going to still sear your ears. And if you set the de-esser for them, then everything else is going to get lispy, and we don't want that. So you have a couple options. The first is you can automate the de-esser, which is a great way to fly. But I got a trick that was taught to me many, many moons ago, and it's very simple, and it looks like this. This is just grabbing the sibilant and pulling it down. And what I love about this method is it gives you so much precise control over exactly what you're doing to the sound. And so a cool thing to do is just set this shape up here over your S or your T or whatever you got, and then pull the bottom part all the way down so you're effectively muting the sibilant. And then loop this little section and just listen to what you're doing, and then grab the front end of the ramp and move it ahead or back in time and just see what it sounds like to leave a little bit of that transient in there. And then go to the back end and tune it so that you're really just getting rid of the sibilant and nothing else. And then you're going to play with the bottom level of the ramp here and figure out exactly how much sibilant you want to leave and how much you want to take away. And it's best to do this, in my opinion, in context. You want to have the music playing, because sibilants, I find, are impossible to tune in solo. And that's because the amount of sibilants that I want to leave in isn't an absolute factor. It depends on what's going on around it. And generally, it relates very specifically to the brightness and the texture of the high-frequency transients, cymbals, percussion, shakers, tambourines, things like that. But also, if you got splashy reverbs, if you've got bright, buzzy synth pads, those are all things that are going to affect how much sibilance you want in the vocal, because sibilance is it's a couple of things, but in addition to texture, so if the sibilant is too sharp or too bright, the texture can get annoying and sound brittle or harsh. But on the flip side, sibilance is clarity. When a vocal is nice and bright and you've got really clear sibilance, you can tuck a vocal in deeper and it'll stay clear. You can understand what the person is saying. So again, you want to tune the sibilance in context so that you can make sure that you're leaving in exactly what's needed, no more, no less. I find that if I've got a de-esser going, sometimes I'll need to pull a sibilant down another 3 or even 6 decibels. And as often as not, on a lead vocal, which is the gem of the mix for me, I won't use a de-esser at all. I will spend, at this point in time, I can do it in 5 to 10 minutes. I can go through an entire vocal track and I can set this shape up for every S and T and offending K and KH and CH and F, everything. And once I've got all those shapes in place, I'll then pull them all down as a starting point around 6 dB. And from there, as the mix progresses, if I find something is a little too lispy or dull, I'll pull that sibilant up. And if I find it gets a little too bright and I want to get more aggressive with it, I'll just pull it down. And I do that on a sibilant by sibilant basis. So I'm really specific and I'm really fastidious about this with a lead vocal, because that lead vocal, I just want that shining perfectly. I don't ever want a harsh moment in there. Unless you want a harsh moment in there, and sometimes you want that, but by and large, you want to keep things smooth and even. You don't want S's jumping out more than T's. For my money, on a lead vocal, my ear generally does a way better job of that than any de-esser or plugin or even analog. So use your automation, de-ess the vocal. So these are the powerful things that automation can do for you in your mixes. Thanks for tuning in. I'm Gregory Scott. This has been Kush After Hours. Till next time.